Today I'd like to show you a basic oil change on the rotary pump, which goes with your sputter, coater, or evaporator. The things we have here on the bench is, this is a Pfeiffer Duo 6 rotary vane pump. It has been disconnected from its station where it normally resides near the carbon coater or sputter coater, whichever it may be. It's unplugged, turned off. Items that you need for this pump is a large screwdriver, a set of metric Allen keys. In particular, you need a 5mm Allen key to open the drain plug. You would need a waste oil container like the one I'm holding here, with a funnel to catch the waste oil. Some Kim wipes, just in case you make a mess. First thing you do is you open the fill port on the top of the pumping end of the rotary vane pump. On that part, you can see that there's a sight glass that shows you the oil level. Usually I run the pump for 5 minutes at least to allow the oil to heat a little bit. Caution, the oil can get up to 60 or 70 degrees Celsius. Running it for 5 minutes just makes it a little bit less viscous and easy to drain out. So using the Allen key, I loosen the drain port and then move it the rest of the way, allowing the oil to drain out. So I mean about getting messy. I've set this up on the end of a bench. So I can tilt it to get all the oil out of the pump. And when it gets to the point where it's just a small amount of oil draining, I will let it drip and put the rotary pump waste oil bucket on the floor right underneath. I will always wear a pair of gloves. And allow the rotary pump to drain completely. Once the pump is drained completely, after allowing it to drip a little bit, get those last few drops, I'll reinstall the drain plug. And tighten that down so it's snug. Wipe up any extra oil. And then I will add fresh oil. This happens to be an Edwards pump, an RV8. Doesn't matter, RV3, RV5, RV8. The process for oil exchange and replacement on a routine basis is the same. These two ports are fill ports, and you don't need any special tools, although they are in tight, so you might get a pair of pliers to loosen it. This is the drain plug down here. You might need a pair of pliers to loosen that also. Again, you have a sight glass, and you can see the oil level. Halfway to three quarters is the usual amount of oil that I put in it. The same procedure as the Pfeiffer, so we don't need to repeat what we just demonstrated. Once the pump is drained and the plug is put back in, using the Supergrade 19 pump oil, which we sell, we'll go ahead and carefully refill the pump. After pouring a little bit, you can see the meniscus of the oil in the sight glass come up. Generally, I will raise it to about two-thirds to three-quarters of the way to the top of the boundary. When the oil warms up, it will expand. So now I consider the oil level full. So I put the fill plug back in. Turn it till it's tight, and that completes the oil exchange process on the Pfeiffer Duo 6.